Okay, this video is called Who Goes Deaf? And we're going to start out with a quote from Goethe, the great German writer-philosopher. He said, "A creation of importance can only be produced when the author isolates himself. It is a child of solitude. I cannot produce anything without absolute solitude." And that's characteristic of people who are thinking and trying to create something. They're thinking. They need quiet and peace. They don't need, like, my dog's barking upstairs. Sorry about that. Okay, the next one is a quote by Arthur Schopenhauer, and then we're going to talk all about deafness. Okay, "The amount of noise which anyone can bear undisturbed stands in inverse proportion to his mental capacity, and may therefore be regarded as a pretty fair measure of it. Noise is a torture to all intelligent people. Noise is the most impertinent form of interruption. A great intellect sinks to ordinary when it is interrupted and distracted, because its superiority depends on its power of focusing all of its strength on one theme. That is why eminent minds have always been so extremely averse to every kind of disturbance and distraction, and while the worst is loud noise, but while the rest of people are not especially troubled by noise." Arthur Schopenhauer. Okay, so, you know, for some jobs, it's obvious that there's a high risk of deafness. If there's lots of loud noise, there's going to be more deafness. The louder the noise, the more frequent the noise exposure, the higher the risk of deafness. And some of them are kind of obvious. Rock and roll musicians that play their music loud, have a lot of rock concerts with loud music. A bartender or a bouncer working in a loud bar every night. Working in a loud factory is one of the most common occupational exposures. You know, they're stuck inside that factory all day long with the loud machines. Landscaping guys, working with lawnmowers and blowers all day, lumberjacks, any of these jobs with these loud machines. Farmers have very often become deaf as they get older from the loud tractors and other equipment they work with. Ambulance drivers from the loud sirens. Motorcycle riders, with motorcycles, the faster they go, the louder those things get. Race car drivers, firecrackers, people who are around these loud noises, they're more likely to be deaf. I went to one rock concert when I was a teenager and my ears hurt afterward. I hated it. It was so crowded and people pushing and it was so loud my ears hurt afterwards. I never went to another rock concert again in my life. When somebody slams a door, I've had people do that. That makes your ears hurt. That's very rude, bad behavior. I also had, you know, my wife, for trying to improve her health, started making smoothies in a blender, and I found it extremely annoying. I hate the loud noise of the blender, and so I would say, "Let me know. I'm going to get out of the kitchen first." And then I figured, oh, she's going to be deaf now too, so I bought her some ear protectors. I already have my own ear protectors just so I can get any work done with all the people around the house. And the other thing too is whenever I'll complain about something, the wife will call me autistic or say you have no common sense. And you know what? That's actually very typical. When somebody doesn't have a good argument, they just, you know, use ad hominem. They say, well, you're an autistic, you're a jerk, or you have no common sense. It's a way to get the subject in a different direction so they can maybe win the argument. Okay, now here's another one. I had a friend who's a pilot, and he had a little party at his house that I went to, and they were watching TV at the UFC fights. And they had the volume very loud. It was so loud that it was hurting my ears. And I said to them, why don't you turn it down? And they said to me, you don't understand. We're all deaf. All pilots are deaf. We spend a lot of time around loud engines, and eventually we all go deaf. Takeoff is very loud. And that's actually the case that anybody that works around airports, around the ground crew, the staff on the plane, they all are exposed to loud noises and often go deaf. I once had a patient who was an audiologist, and a lot of times if I have a patient, you know, an older person or somebody with a reasonable amount of experience, I'll ask them, what have you learned in your job that you think would be helpful if other people would know it? And the guy said to me that deafness can happen after just one rock concert. He also said the guys who was kind of surprised him to see often go deaf are guys who work in a tire shop because of the sudden increase in pitch and pressure with the tire inflation, you know, air pressure machine. Thought that was interesting. And then I notice as I walk around, I sometimes see construction workers, and I notice a lot of them don't wear ear protectors. Meanwhile, they're working with these drills and other power tools that have a sudden ramp up in loudness and pitch. And I'm thinking, gosh, that's just like the air pressure machine or the blender for the smoothies. And, you know, I looked it up. Yeah, a lot of construction workers go deaf. And one study I read is like almost half of them eventually go deaf at a premature age. And I thought to myself, well, what doctors are most at risk to go deaf? And then it was pretty obvious. I thought it's got to be orthopedic surgeons because they're constantly working with drills, power saws, electric saws, and all these other tools. And so I looked it up. Yeah, the orthopedic surgeons have an increased incidence of becoming deaf. And then I thought, well, who else works with drills all the time? Dentists. Dentists work in drill, and they got that high-speed drill and stuff. They have a high increased incidence of deafness. But, you know, most of the people who are deaf, they don't have any of these risk factors. It's mostly old people. And why do old people go deaf, so many of them? It's from atherosclerosis. Same old story. No blood flow, body don't go. And it's very common they get atherosclerosis in arteries all over their bodies from hypertension, from tobacco, high-fat diets, diabetes. And it's associated with all the usual stuff, coronary artery disease, impotence, etc. So anyways, if you avoid atherosclerosis and you don't be around loud, excessive noises, you probably won't go deaf. Anyways, hope that was interesting.